Electrolysis, it's very interesting and very easy topic. But before this, I want to explain some terms that will be used in this topic. For example, ionic substances. Ionic substances are those substances in which positive and negative ions are held together through the ionic bond. They have strong electrostatic force of attraction. They cannot conduct the electric current when they are in the solid form. And they only conduct the electricity when they are in the solution form or in molten form. Two types of the ions, cations and anions. Cations have positive charge, anions have negative charge. During the electrolysis process, the positive ion moves towards the cathode, this is the name of the electrode, and negative ion moves towards the anode. And cathode electrode is also called negative electrode, and anode is also called positive electrode. The next term is the electrolyte. Electrolyte is the substance that allow the electric current to pass through it when it is in the molten or in solution form. For example, sodium chloride, zinc chloride, sodium sulfate, silver nitrate, when they are in the solid form, they cannot conduct the electricity. Actually, they are ionic compounds. When they are in molten form or in solution form, they convert into the positive and negative ions, and these positive and negative ions move towards their respective electrodes. Conductor. Conductor is like electrolyte, but they are in the solid form. For example, copper, metal, zinc, platinum, these are conductors because they have free electrons and current can pass through them due to the movement of the free electrons. Electrodes are conductors through which the electricity enter or leave the object, substance or region. Electrochemistry is the branch of science which deals with the conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy or chemical energy into electrical energy. And then there is another term, electrochemical cells. Electrochemical cells are used for the conversion of electrical energy into chemical and chemical into electrical energy. The cell which convert the electrical energy into chemical energy are called electrolytic cell, and the cell that convert the chemical energy into electrical energy are called galvanic or voltaic cell. Now I will start electrolysis. Electrolysis means decomposition. Ionic substances, when they are in the molten form or in solution form, when electric current pass through them, they convert into the positive and negative ions. This is called electrolysis. For this process, we need a cell. In this cell, we use electrodes. And we have these two electrodes. One is called anode and other is cathode. And we need one power supply, that is battery. And the electrode that is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, it is called cathode, and it is also called negative electrode. And the electrode that is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, it's called anode, and it is also called positive electrode. Now we need one tank that should have the molten solution or aqueous solution of any electrolyte. For example, if we have a molten solution of sodium chloride, here we have many sodium positive ions and chloride negative. There are many ions inside this solution. This solution is electrically neutral. When current is not passing through it, it's a neutral solution. It has equal number of chloride and sodium ions. When current passes through this solution, the positive ions moves towards the cathode. All the positive ions, they will be attracted by the cathode because cathode is negative electrode and it will attract the oppositely charged ions. Here the sodium have positive charge. So positively charged ions will be attracted by the negative cathode, and all the negative ions, they will be attracted by the anode, and anode has positive charge. That's why all the negative ions, they will move towards the anode.
Here, all the negative ions, chloride ions, they move towards the anode. At the surface of the anode, they release the electron. I will write here Cl minus minus one electron, because one electron will be removed from this chloride ion, and it will convert into chlorine. As we know that the chlorine exists in diatomic form, so I will write this equation again. There will be another chloride ion from the solution. It will go to the anode and release the electron here and convert into chlorine.
And these two neutral chlorine, they will combine with each other through the covalent bonding, and in the form of chlorine gas they will release at the anode. Now here chlorine gas will release at the anode.
There is oxidation reduction reaction during the electrolysis process. Here in this case, the chloride ions, when they reach at the surface of the anode, they release the electron and oxidize to chlorine. And always there is a process of oxidation at the anode and reduction at the cathode. All the negative ions, chloride ions, when they reach at the surface of the anode, they release the electron and they convert into the chlorine. It means chloride ions are oxidized. Here the electrons are released by the negative ion, chloride ions. They will enter into the external circuit. They will move from anode to cathode. It means the external circuit is completed by the movement of the electron from anode to cathode, and at the cathode they will be absorbed by the positive ions, and these positive ions will be reduced. It means a reduction process will occur at the surface of the cathode.
At cathode, sodium ions, or all the positive ions that are present in the solution, they will be attracted by the cathode, because cathode has negative charge. So all the sodium ions, they will move towards the cathode, and here what they will do, all the sodium, they have positive charge, they will accept the electron. The same electron that came from anode through the external circuit, and these electrons are now present at the cathode. So these positive ions, they will take this electron and convert into sodium neutral, and addition of the electron is called reduction. It means the reduction will occur at the cathode and oxidation always at the anode. And electrons, they move from anode to cathode. Always they move from anode to cathode. All the positive ions moves towards the cathode, or cation moves towards the cathode, and anions moves towards the anode. At the anode, the anions release their electron and oxidation occur, and these anions convert into the neutral atoms. In this case, chlorine gas will be released at the anode, because the chloride ions, they release the electron and convert into the chlorine, and chlorine is diatomic molecule. In nature it exists in the form of the Cl2. So two chlorine atoms, they combine with each other through the covalent bonding, and chlorine gas will release at the anode. And on the other side, at the cathode, cation moves towards the cathode. They absorb the electron, this electron that came from the anode through the external circuit, and sodium, when they absorb the electron, they convert into the neutral sodium. As the reaction is going to proceed at the high temperature, so the sodium will be in the molten form and it will be deposited at the cathode electrode. During this whole process, we have two components. One is chlorine gas that release at the anode, and other is the sodium metal that has been deposited at the cathode. And another thing here, the electrodes should be inert. Why they should be inert? Because during the electrolysis process, they should not react with the electrolyte or they should not react with the metals or nonmetals that are produced during the this reaction. For example, the electrolyte, here we are taking sodium chloride, and chlorine gas and sodium metal is produced. These electrodes should not react with the sodium metal, and also it should not react with the chlorine gas. So the electrode should be inert. And electrodes can be metals or sometimes non-metal. For example, platinum, copper, zinc and silver we can take as the electrode. And the non-metal like graphite, it can be used as the electrode. Next topic is electrolysis of the solution. Electrolysis of the solution is more complicated than molten solution. Because in case of the molten solution, for example, sodium chloride is in a molten form, we see that we have two type of the ions, positive sodium and negative chloride ion. We can say that the sodium will deposit at the cathode and chlorine gas will release at the anode. But if we have aqueous solution of sodium chloride, then we have two type of the positive ions. Because at the same time when sodium chloride convert into the sodium ions and chloride ion, water also release the hydrogen ion and hydroxide ions. So we have sodium and hydrogen, they two type of the positive ions and two type of the negative ions, chloride and hydroxide ions. It means the positive ions, sodium and hydrogen ions, they will move towards the cathode, and chloride and hydroxide ions moves towards the anode. There is a reduction process at the cathode and oxidation process at the anode, but there is competition between the positive ions at the cathode and there is also competition between the negative ions at the anode. And which ion will deposit and which will remain in the solution, it depends upon the reactivity series of the metals and non-metals. According to the reactivity series, we have to arrange the metals according to their reactivity.
To explain the electrolysis of the solutions, let's take another example of copper bromide. Copper bromide is also an ionic compound.
And when copper bromide is in the aqueous form, it will convert into copper positive ions and bromide ions. At the same time, we have positive and negative ions from water also, hydrogen and hydroxide ions. And copper and hydrogen ion, they will move towards the cathode, and hydroxide ions and bromide ions, they will move towards the anode. Now, at the cathode, there are two type of the positive ions, and at the anode, we have also two type of the negative ions. There is competition between the positive ions at the cathode, and also at the anode, there is competition between the two type of the negative ions. The element here, the ions that have less reactivity, they will release at the electrodes, and the other ion, they will remain in the solution. In case of the copper and hydrogen, if we see the reactivity series, in this reactivity series, copper is below the hydrogen. Here we have copper and hydrogen at the cathode, and at the cathode there is competition between the copper and hydrogen. Copper is below the hydrogen. It means copper has less reactivity as compared to hydrogen. So less reactive elements, they will deposit at the electrode and the other will remain in the solution.
Here, as the copper is less reactive as compared to the hydrogen, so it will absorb the electron at the cathode and deposit at the surface of the cathode, and hydrogen will remain in the solution.
Copper at the cathode, it will absorb two electron and convert into the copper neutral metal in the solid form. It will deposit at the electrode here. Here it will deposit at the cathode. cathode, and the process is reduction. Now the copper absorb the electron, reduction process occur, it will deposit at the cathode, and at the same time there is another process, oxidation, that will occur at the anode. Now what will happen here are the hydroxide ions and bromide ions at the anode.
Here in the case of the negative ions, there are two factors. One is the reactivity and other is the concentration of the ions. As we know that water is weak electrolyte, there are a few number of the hydroxide ions, and if we have less number of the hydroxide ions as compared to the bromide ions, the bromide ions they will move towards the anode, and at the anode they will release the electron and oxidized, and then they will convert into the bromine, and bromine will deposit at the anode, and hydroxide ions they will remain in the solution. So bromide ions they will release the electron at the surface of the anode, and at the anode there is the process of the oxidation due to the removal of the electron from the bromide ions, and bromine is present in nature in the form of the liquid. So we will see the layer of the colored bromine around the anode.
At the anode, oxidation process, and when I add these two equations, so there is copper and this electron that has been released at the anode, they move here at the anode, these electrons they move from anode to cathode, and these are absorbed by the copper. So I will cancel these electrons, copper in the form of the solid pure metal and bromine in the aqueous form, it will be around the anode. So another thing that the covalent compounds, they cannot conduct the electricity. The answer of this question is this, that because the covalent compound, they are found by sharing the electron, there is no positive or negative ions, and when there is no positive or negative ions, they will not conduct the electricity, because conductance is due to the movement of the electrons and movement of the ions. Because if we see this cell, the electrons complete the external circuit, and internal circuit it is completed by the movement of the positive and negative ions toward the respective electrodes. In case of the covalent compounds, when there is no positive and negative ions, they will not move in the solution towards their respective electrodes, and when there is no ion, then there is no addition or removal of the electrons.
Here, to complete the external circuit, we need the electron, and these electron will move from anode to cathode. And when we have a covalent compound, they have no ions between the two electrodes to complete the internal circuit also. So covalent compounds cannot conduct the electricity. We need also ionic compounds in molten form or in aqueous form. If they are present in the solid form, they cannot conduct the electricity, because in solid form they are also present in the crystalline form.
Example, sodium chloride, when it is in the solid form, it is in the form of the crystals like this. It is in the cubic form, and all the positive and negative ions are fixed at their position. For example, if here is sodium, is chloride, and all the positive and negative ions, they are at their fixed position. So these ions, when they are at their fixed position, they cannot move. In ionic, all the ionic substances, when they are present in the solid form, they are in a crystalline form, and they form the giant lattice structure. And in this structure, the positive and negative ions are not free to move, so they cannot conduct the electricity. we can study the conductance of the ionic substances when they are present in the molten form or in the aqueous form. When they are in the molten form or aqueous form, these positive negative ions, they leave their spaces, they are free to move, and then they can move towards the respective electrodes, and there is the process of oxidation and reduction, and by the removal or addition of the electrons, the conductance is possible. So ionic substances, they conduct the electricity only in the molten or aqueous form, and covalent compounds, they cannot conduct the electricity because they have no positive or negative ions, and if they have no positive or negative ions, then this process is not possible.